Hello, welcome back to the channel. My name's Stuart and I'm a professional software engineer, and I've been writing code since the days of Spectrums and BBC Micros. So what I'm going to do today is show you how to talk to your radio from code. We're going to use OmniRig. OmniRig allows us to do this very quickly, which is why it's such a great thing. So let's jump into it. We're going to use Visual Studio and we're going to write the code in C sharp. Let's just assume that OmniRig is installed and connected and working. We're going to create a forms app. Now, I know a lot of people don't like forms, it's a bit old school, but who cares? It's going to allow me to demonstrate this very easily. So we'll just do forms.net framework. So let's just create, just leave all that as default, next, and we'll do .NET 6, why not? Just because we can. We've got it installed, but it doesn't really matter, to be honest, whichever one you pick, it'll work. So this will fire up a very basic empty program. So if you've never done programming before, if I run this program, we will get, when it runs, I'll skip that. There we go. We've got a program. We didn't do anything. All we did is create a project and we've got a program, a Windows desktop application. And if you can imagine, if I fire up Station Master is exactly the same. I've just added more stuff. So that's how I've built Station Master, exactly this way, .NET 6 WinForms application. Right, so we'll stop debugging. And what we're going to do on the left-hand side, you've got toolbars, and we're going to drag in a text box. So I just search for text box, drag it in, drop. There we go. We'll make it a bit wider. And what we can do is right-click properties, and down on the bottom right-hand side over here, we can make it bigger. So if we go into font and set the font size to, let's say, 24, so it's really big, and we'll set some text, some default text in this box. We'll scroll down in text, we'll just put, I don't know, 7.125, and we'll just assume that that's the frequency that the radio is going to be on by default. There we go. We'll run it again. And what have we got? We're going to have just the same as what we had before, except for we've got a text box. We can type into that. We can delete. We've got a text box with a number in it. That's all we've got. It won't do anything other than that. Now let's connect it to the radio. So what we need to do here is in the main project window on the right hand side under dependencies, we need to link it to OmniRig. We need to add a COM reference. In here, we can, under COM, we can search for OmniRig. There we go, OmniRig version 1. Click on that, tick the box, click OK. We now have a reference to OmniRig. That will only work if OmniRig's installed on the local computer. Okay, so next step, if we go, just double click on this title bar at the top, the blue bit, just double click and it will take us into the code. So this code fires as soon as the program launches, which is why it's called form 1 load. Form 1 is this box here. It's a form, a Windows form. And when this loads up, it's going to run the code between these curly braces, and we want it to do something. We want a timer. So let's say timer t equals new. There we go. I've been programming in a different language all day, so I've forgotten how to code. Now, so we want a timer, but our system doesn't know what a timer is. So hover your mouse, click on the little yellow dot. Let's use Windows Forms timer. That's the one we want. T dot. So how often do we want this timer to tick? We want it to tick every 100 milliseconds. And what do we want it to do when it ticks? Dot. What does it do? Ticks. It ticks. So you do that, and then you do plus equals, and then you do tab. Press your tab button, and it'll automatically generate code down here. this code will fire every time this timer ticks. So once every 100 milliseconds, so that's 10 times a second, this code between here will fire. So all we've done there is said we want a timer that we want a little timer that runs 10 times a second, and 10 times a second we want it to run the code over here. What this is going to do is check the radio to see what frequency it's on and put it in the tick in the box. So let's search for something OmniRig. OmniRig O equals new OmniRig. Now I've completely forgotten how to do this, so I'm going to load up my other program where I've already done this before. And we're going to, so this is the good thing about when, you know, when you've been programming a long time, because you've already done something in the past, you just go back and look at your old code. So what we need to do is, right, so up here, a reference to OmniRig, and we'll copy this code here. So what this is going to do, it's going to try and create a link to OmniRig. If it fails, as in there's an exception, it will pop up and say OmniRig isn't installed, or that's a pop-up message. So that's what that does. And then what do we want to do? We want to poll we just want to get the frequency from the radio. So that's how we do that, that bit of code there. Okay, so we're going to say the text box 1, which is the text box that we added, text is going to be equal to OmniRig rig 1 get frequency. Now the problem here is it returns an integer, so what we can do, all we do is at the end just do to string with some brackets, and that will convert it to a text. There we go. That is it. That is literally all you need to do. Let's run it. Skip the symbol loading. If I turn my VFO, there we go. We've just created a program that talks to OmniRig. Okay, so there we have it. All the code that you need to use OmniRig to read the frequency from a radio. Let's just run it again. We're not going to do the mode thing because that looked a bit more complicated than I wanted to do in this video. Turning the VFO now. Happy days. And what you can also see is I've got another program running over here that's also tracking the frequency. And if I fire up Station Master, which is my log program, that also uses OmniRig. And if I turn it on, so we've got all these different things here, all these different things all talking to the radio at the same time, reading the frequency. And that's how they do it. If they're using OmniRig, that is how they do it. They've basically written exactly the same code as what I've done there, perhaps in a different language. But it doesn't matter, because it's a COM reference, you can basically use this in any language that supports COM, which is pretty much all of them. Okay, there we go. Hope you found that useful. If you're a developer, then if you've tried to create a C# app that talks to OmniRig, it's quite hard to find some example code. I did manage to find some, and I managed to figure out how to do it all. But if you're not a developer and you're just interested in how all these things talk to radios, then there you go, you've learned something. And maybe it'll inspire you to create yourself a little app. You can download Visual Studio for free. Just type in Visual Studio Community Edition and just install it. When it does the installation, just say you want to do .NET development, including desktop development. And this is a Windows form application. It's the easiest way to create Windows applications. There are newer other ways of doing it, but they add complexity. And yeah, I've stuck with Windows forms. I've been using it since .NET began, so I'm not going to change now. Thanks for watching. And if you like this, subscribe, and maybe I'll do a few other things like this as well in the future.